4. Let's open our coverage with that IEBC report. And the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission Chairman Wafula Chebukati has defended his six-year tenure at the electoral body, saying that he performed his duties in line with the Constitution. Chebukati, who concludes his term tomorrow, Tuesday of the 17th January 2023, said that one of his major achievements, it was the executing the 2022 general poll, which he termed as one of the most transparent. Why? Because of the public portal that saw results being accessible to all. Nancy Okware with the details.
Hours until his term as the chairman of the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission comes to an end, Wafula Chebukati presided over the launch of the 2022 post-election evaluation report. The report, a requirement by the Constitution, outlines successes, failures, and recommends what needs to be improved in future. Chebukati saying that in the last general elections, the public portal eliminated any avenue of election malpractice, while printing ballot papers equal to the number of registered voters prevented cases of ballot stuffing.
A record 386 million logins were reported to the portal, and those that tallied the results got the same results as the IBC result in Form 34C.
We must appreciate the work of the IBC, the work that the IBC did in the last elections in conducting what will perhaps objectively go down in our history as one of the most credible and transparent general elections.
Chebukati adding that the 2022 election saw a reduction in cost, as some KIMS kits purchased in 2017 were reused, with only 14,000 new devices bought to replace faulty ones.
For example, ballot papers in 2017 were paying about 150 shillings per ballot paper, but in 2022 we will pay 25 shillings per ballot paper. So the cost of elections was reduced.
Chebukati, however, noting that despite the achievements, highly ethnicized and divisive politics still remained a challenge alongside attempts to erode the commission's independence.
The 2022 general elections witnessed probably the gravest attempts to usurp the independence of the commission and the sovereign will of the people of Kenya as expressed in the polls.
Kenyan citizens deserved 10 out of 10 for their stellar performance. They saved the elections.
If we don't actually ensure that young people understand how elections affect them, literally, apart from them just showing up to vote, then I think we'll continue seeing this dent in our democracy.
Chebukati's six-year term is set to elapse on Tuesday, alongside that of Commissioners Abdi Gulie and Boya Molu.
I exit a very contented man, and I say we gave it our best.
We went into hiding. We had to put off our phones, leave them in Bomas, send away our security, and we rode in Anoa to an unknown location.
I was also number two in the irreducible minimum, but they have only managed to reduce the number of the commissioners, but we remain.
Even when some pay the ultimate price for their integrity with their lives, as happened with the returning officer in Embakasi, this country owes you a debt of gratitude.
As he prepares to exit office on Tuesday, the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission chairperson Wafula Chebukati has maintained that during his tenure at the electoral body, he performed his duties according to the rule of law and that he has no regrets. Nancy Okware, Prime Edition, Nairobi.